This video presents some additional capabilities of the railing edit mode, which is used to edit the geometry of the individual railing sub-elements created by the ArchiCAD railing tool. As shown in the previous clip in this playlist, the railing edit mode lets you edit any of the railing components in a graphical way in any model viewpoint. ArchiCAD offers additional railing editing, which makes it possible to customize each individual component or sub-element of the railing to your exact needs. These additional commands are offered in the context menu of the selected railing elements. For the first command, let's consider a railing placed on an L-shaped stair. The railing has two user-created nodes at the starting and endpoints of the stair baseline, with an automatic node at the turning of the stair. All railing segments between the two user-created nodes share the same segment pattern. In Railing Edit mode, let's right-click the Segments and Node button in the Railing Toolbox, which will make those components visible and hide all other components, a handy shortcut. If we click any segment, we will see that the segments are selected. Any change performed will be applied to all these segments. The segments cannot be selected individually. This is also true for nodes. If we click a node, we'll see that all nodes of the railing are selected. To enable the individual modification of segments and nodes, click any segment to select all segments. Then right-click and activate the Create Independent Segments and Nodes command of the context menu. Alternately, click on any node to select all nodes, then activate the context menu command. All segments and nodes that were selected together are now independent. This means that the segment pattern of one segment can be different from the segment pattern of other segments. For example, you may use balusters in one segment and use a glass panel in another. For the second context menu command, let's now consider a single and now independent segment of the railing. Let's click any of the panels, and we will see that all panels of the segment are selected. Here, the segment length is greater than the segment pattern length, so the pattern is repeated multiple times within the segment. The individual repeating components of the pattern, including inner posts, balusters, and panels, cannot be independently modified. All changes made to a component type are applied to all its instances within the segment. To enable the modification of these individual pattern component instances, select any of the components of the segment, then right-click and activate the Convert Pattern to Segment Length command of the context menu. As a result, each pattern instance will now be considered internally by ArchiCAD as a separate railing segment. And thus, each individual instance of each component type of the segment can now be selected and its settings modified. This provides the ultimate in customization because this way each and every component of a railing can be modified individually. The third context menu command lets you flip a placed railing to the opposite side of the railing reference line. Select the railing, then right-click and activate the Flip Railing on Reference Line command from the context menu. The operation can be performed both inside and outside the railing edit mode. As a result, the geometry of the railing will be flipped to the other side of its reference line. Handrails, rails, balusters, and panels, if they are horizontally offset from the railing reference plane, will be flipped to the opposite side. Please also watch the other clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the capabilities of the railing tool.